It's going to be a little bit different today because I'm going to be writing not in my notebook or journal, but on a piece of paper, and I'm not going to be using my fountain pen, but a dip pen. you need to change your plans. You might even find yourself changing your goals. That's okay too. The important thing is that you at least have goals that you are refining and calibrating. Refining and calibrating. Some of you may want to recite a mantra, or write out your intentions in a journal, or simply meditate, or do all three, or none at all. What is important is to do the things that you find works for you. If you would like to start to apply these suggestions, let me know how you are progressing. Good luck. Discussion I had with a friend today while out on a walk. We often discuss and update ourselves on our lives, not so much personal, but career. And he is the CEO of a company, and the founder of the company. And we often share work dynamics. And one of the things that he had brought up was that it's really important for people to know what their values are. Sometimes you really don't know what your values are unless you really think about it. And the reason why this came up was because often when you are in a meeting and you make a suggestion, and even though the suggestion you had made to the team is a good one, and the decision maker or the CEO may not exactly see the value and benefit of it right away. In fact, the CEO might actually say no to your suggestion. And when this happens, sometimes there are reasons why. And when this happens, sometimes it could be because the suggestion that you made may have inadvertently be perceived that we were stepping on an area that is very dear to them. And they don't realize it, but this that you are making a suggestion about could really have a lot of value to this person. And the reason why they may initially reject your suggestion is because it didn't come from them. And maybe they subconsciously perceive that you are making a suggestion that you really don't have any reason to weigh in on, because they're the ones that have more buy-in. And this goes the same for you. When you make a suggestion in a meeting or to a team and it gets rejected for that time and you feel frustrated and upset, it could be because that rejection of an idea is taken personally, but you don't even know it. You don't even know that. And that's why it's important to really know your values. Because if you did know your values, what is really important to you. And I'm not talking about like the values or religion, it goes deeper. There's so many levels and layers that we are made of. It's not just one thing, but it comes from experiences in our childhood. And as we grow older, these experiences start to everything we perceive gets added to it. And often things that we don't even know why we're reacting, and that ties into values. If I'm not clear, I'm only just expressing what I have understood in the words that I'm using. I can easily elaborate in another video, because this is just something that you don't hear once and then understand it and then be aware of it. And when you have a situation like that in a meeting, so that was probably why I wrote this letter. Inspired by conversation I had during a walk with my friend who is a CEO of a company. I really appreciate this friend in very many ways. He's somewhat a mentor, but more of an equal and colleague when it comes to personal and professional situations that we share that have happened in our lives or are happening in our lives. And I've known this friend for 8 years now, and I really value the friendship and the feedback, the honest feedback. And the one thing I like about this friendship is that we are equal, even though we have different careers and are on different paths. We respect one another, and many times the things and the topics we share, we or it actually allows one either of us to together and see how it applies to us. And that's where it's really almost like bi-directional or omnidirectional learning. I think I just got that word from using the Yeti microphone, and they talk about bi-directional and omnidirectional settings. Isn't that funny? Anyway, make so these papers to look like old parchment paper, and if you notice, when I was taking the dip pen and writing, there's parts of the paper that's crinkled, and the tip of the nib would get stuck on the grooves of these crinkles, so it's not quite a smooth stroke. Because of these crinkles, these little crinkles, and it didn't make for a smooth up and down stroke. So if you were liking the sound, the writing sounds, and then there'd be an abrupt stop because of the tip of the nib got caught on the crinkles, that might have for some of you, when the tip of the nib, but for some of you, when the tip of the nib would glide along the paper and get caught, crinkles, and created a different rhythm or sound, then gave you tingles. Who knows? That's what's so interesting about ASMR. Everyone has different triggers, and there are patterns of triggers or combinations. You like whispering, it doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to like all types of whispering, because there are voices that may not resonate with you. One voice that sends tingles and shivers down the base of your brain to the top of your spine may not same effect with another person, and in fact, that person may not be able to stand the person's voice, which I find interesting. It's just funny how our brains are, or how we are wired. I know people, like I said before in my previous video, people that don't get tingles at all, and they don't understand what ASMR is, or how people can have these tingles, and they don't even understand why ASMR or the ASMR community is just growing and getting a lot of attention. And there are people who absolutely do not understand ASMR artists. Now, in terms of ASMR artists, do I consider myself an ASMR artist? Honestly, no. I don't know that ASMR I, to be honest, haven't really, in my process, really planned out or have given a lot of thought to initiating or eliciting types of triggers. Right now, I am at the level of just creating tingles, then that just makes me really happy. I haven't really reached a point in my process where I think about doing a video and really be aware of the type of trigger I want to elicit. Meaning, some people I see, some ASMR artists, they're very deliberate in their hand movements, and their triggers, and how their voice resonates from within. The microphone, whereas I haven't gotten to that level of detail of awareness yet. That is why I do not consider myself an ASMR artist. Maybe one day in a couple of years, as the channel grows, as I become more intent with each video or each movement or each whisper or choice of words, then perhaps only then will I feel that I am an ASMR artist. But right now, I'm just having a lot of fun. And I hope that you continue to visit my channel and see how I progress. And I welcome any comment you have. Like I said, I just started my first ASMR video, I believe April 11th of this year. And I want to be consistent in making videos. And it's not just a matter of just making videos for videos. I do it because, like I said, it's fun and I enjoy it. And it's my way of relaxing. And it allows me to stop and do something other than work. And I really hope that as I continue to create content for the community, then one day I will be considered an ASMR artist. Now, with that said, can you hear in the background that there are cars outside revving their engine? It's quite annoying because it's almost like they're drag racing. And now the sound of the fridge just turned on. And I can easily get frustrated at these different sounds. And I hope it doesn't take away from this experience. But with that said, I think it's time for you to go to sleep. Okay, time to go to sleep. Okay, go to sleep. Go to sleep. Go to sleep. to sleep. Night.